Starting a new game real quick. What's going on, everybody? Recently, I played through Donkey Kong Country 1 with a buddy of mine. And I want to jump into Diddy's Conquest while I'm warmed up in the Donkey Kong series. A lot of people say this is their favorite, and I can see why. It definitely fleshes out the lore of the series, and especially the Kremlings, and it just has a lot of emphasis on characters, the Kremlings, where they come from, the kidnapping of Donkey Kong, and there's just a lot of new, fresh character designs. And it's just an overall great game. They really did a great job building off of the first game. So I really, really love this game. And in my opinion, it's much harder than the original. I mean, the original has its stages. Granted, like, especially in the snow. Snow stages are really hard. And a few of the later stages in Donkey Kong Country 1 get very challenging. So not discrediting it there. But I think, my personal opinion, I think Donkey Kong Country 2 is definitely the most challenging in the series. A lot of people don't talk about Donkey Kong Country 3. I don't know why. I think that one's great as well. But I could see it definitely took a step back from Part 2. So, again, I think the pinnacle of the series is Donkey Kong Country 2. And I much more enjoy using Dixie than I do DK, just because DK tends to be heavier and he just feels clunkier as a character. So I think in Part 2 they really nailed it, because you essentially have a second Diddy in a sense, even though, you know, Dixie is her own character, but, you know, her core mechanics feels a lot more like Diddy than it does Donkey Kong. So with that said too, I just feel like it just plays smoother. The platforming is smoother. The worlds are fleshed out a lot more. And, like I said, just the lore in general, there's so much built off of the first game. So I just cleared out a couple save states. So I'm going to go ahead and start a fresh game now. And today I'm going solo. So, I have beaten this game one time, and that's it. So it's been quite a long time since I've played Part 2. So I usually play more of 1 than 2. Just like I said, if I'm gonna sit down and do a full playthrough, Part 1 I can really run through, but Part 2, like I said, it's a lot more challenging, so. And I don't really go for, like, 100% complete game. I just play as I go. You know, I enjoy, just playing through games. I feel like we don't always have, you know, we always have a limited amount of time each day. So, to me, it's like, I would love to 100% in certain games, but you know, there's so many things out there I want to try that that's kind of why I don't do it, especially with RPGs now. Like, I would love to go back and just, like, you know, fully play through an RPG, find everything there is to offer. But when you have, you know, limited amount of time, well, I thought I could make that. It just makes it difficult to really do that. So to me, it's like, if I'm gonna allocate 4 or 5 hours of my day to a game, you know, I just want to play through it and say I've beaten it, you know. And plus, there's just so many good games out there I want to play. There's a lot of Genesis stuff I want to try, and I always feel that's one of the libraries that are most underrated is the Genesis. Nice. So what was that? 3 up I got right there. So that's a nice little start. I've been going through a lot of the Sega library lately, and I've found a lot of really good stuff on there. I wanna stream here soon when I when I can. But I figured, hey, I recently played DK1, so let's keep on going. See if I can get this coin. Ooh, I thought I was gonna get hit there. Trying to figure out how to tag. Guys, if you haven't checked me out before, thank you so much for kind of coming in and checking out the stream. I have an Instagram, Rockin' Cat Reviews, which I like to do periodic posts on. I like to do like little mini reviews and stuff like that. And then, oh, I totally missed that. And then, TikTok I have as well. And I also have a Gmail, so you guys need to contact me for anything. But, all the same handles, Rockin' Cat Reviews, you can find me there. So, I like to usually post updates when I'm going to stream too, so. Okay, find the token. And that one's pretty clever. You should at least, like, be able to grip onto a ledge of a barrel like that if they're stacked together. Is there anywhere I can get in there? Guess not. Probably have to do it from over here, maybe? Those guys, I liked how they looked in the first one a lot better. They look kind of too small for their size. They looked like a lot bigger before, weren't they? In part one. Or they're just beefier. Who knows? I got invincibility. Damn. There we go. Really doing a pretty decent job getting the one up, so. where to? Pirate panic. Lockjaw's locker. I love the music on the stage. I need to get up there. I know if you guys can hear me okay. You know, one great thing about water levels in Donkey Kong Country is that it's not realistic, meaning you don't need air, or at least air bubbles, like as you progress. Because, I mean, games are already like a fantasy world, you know, so why it needs to be that realistic is beyond me. It used to drive me crazy in Sonic when I had to get the air bubbles. Like, that used to drive me crazy. Cause it's like, it's already, you know, it's already a fantasy world I'm in already, like, so, but I understand it, but it's just, I love the water levels in DK, and they never feel tedious, like, I actually enjoy playing them. Jump? Yes, I did. But that's not the way I need to go. Guessing I need to get... There we go. Ooh. Did not see him coming. Oh my god, I don't know why I thought I could jump on him. Okay, let's do that again. Hello. I remember what the banana coins do. I'm not 100% sure. Oh, I think you have to use them to like save your game, or I think they're currency when you go to the library or Cranky Kong's wife's, whatever the fuck this is. Yeah, Khan College. I think that's where you use them. Yep, I never go there, so. It's like Little Necky. With him, I feel like there's no point of actually throwing the eggs, just kind of walk right into him. That should just do it. Get him. I was getting pissed. I love like the whole piratey theme in this one. Like, they were already kind of pirates in the original, but they weren't like truly fleshed out like how they are here, you know. But the Kremlins just look awesome. Like, Pirate Necky is so cool. Oh, these fucking stages, the lava ones. Like, they don't fuck around. Like, look at this. They already like threw you in the fucking lava stages. Like, that wouldn't like Mario anything that's like lava base is what like World 8. This game, they don't fuck around. Okay, so those don't hop or bounce. And those guys look so cool. Later, dude. Okay, those are the ones that raise their snout, so just gotta remember which ones they are. There you go. Boom, boom. How does he? Really? There we go. Find the token. I don't understand why he can't jump on anything. He literally has fucking sneakers on. Okay, so I want to go to, where do I want to go? Cannon's Claim. Oh. Can I get over there? Probably, whoops. You probably really gotta like be very precise with that jump then. Unless this sends you there. I can come over here maybe. I love that, that's so cool. That's close. What's up, Cody? I'm playing some DKC in honor of you right now. Thanks for logging in. Play some Crash Bandicoot tomorrow. There we go. I'm getting close to the end of the stage. Oh, there it is. Boom. Okay, so Lava Lagoon. You can see the game already starts getting tough, so I'll probably start getting zoned in here pretty soon. I wonder, has anyone played the Donkey Kong Country Returns games for the Wii and Wii U? I've played the Wii version, and that water got hot quick. It's a great game. I just wish they kept kind of the same art direction as they did in these. But they're still very good games. I just feel like the Donkey Kong game could never kind of recapture that same style of the Super Nintendo games. That's just me, though. Like, the Wii Country Returns games look great. But just the art style just of these games just looks so good. And they make Donkey Kong just look like a beast. Like, I feel like now you look at Donkey Kong and they kind of make him kind of like a little goofy. Like, too goofy, but I always felt like in the this trilogy of games, Donkey Kong was always just taken more serious. Like, he just, I don't know, he didn't come off as a goofball. And maybe that's not what they were intending, but I always felt like the tone of these games were much more serious. So I guess I took the characters more serious, you know? Like, they didn't feel like goofballs, I guess, to me. They felt like their their adventure was really serious, you know? So, okay, Red Hot Ride. Tag team. Oh, I'm gonna just throw the barrel at him. Never mind. Oh, that worked. God, the team attack is so good. Oh, shit. Let's do that again. Okay, let's do this. Boom. No! Oh my god. I'm just not gonna use him then. To say the least, Rambi makes this a lot easier, so. Do I want to switch balloons? Sure. Okay, we made it. I guess that's kind of the plus of having Rambi. You can just power through everything there. I I know a lot of people probably wonder why this game wasn't on the Super NES Classic over the original. But, I mean, the original is the original, but I think for some people, I'm not just saying this to be, like, narcissistic or anything, I think this game would probably be a lot harder for people, and they'd probably put it down quicker than they would the original. Yeah, like the platforming in this game is much more precise. They really need a Donkey Kong Country Returns 3. Oh, nope. I don't know why they didn't ever give us a third one. Like, that should have just been a trilogy in its own too. Of those lives back that I lost. Okay, so Squawk's Shaft. Let's see how this one is. This one's gonna be tough. I can already tell. Fucking barrels are gonna be ridiculous on this one. Boop. There we go. Oh, I didn't get the K. Well, that's good. Good shot. Definitely a challenging level. You really gotta move quick. Okay, Cleaver's Kiln. It's that giant death sword. Bink. Never really expected a boss like this. Oh, I thought I got killed. Ooh, he's coming. Oh, how do you get that last one? There we go. I think I got him. Yeah, you just gotta stay above him. Stay ahead of him. Such a cool boss. Okay, so we are on to Kremque. Did I say that right? I'm going to use the restroom and I will be right back and we'll continue on. So I'm moving on to the sunken destroyed pirate ship Barrel Bayou. So hit by him. He's not gonna move, is he? I never trust myself cartwheeling into certain enemies. Always miss at least one. There we go. Okay. I think this is the one with the parrot. I can see what I'm doing. There he is. What's going on, little buddy? Nice of you to join us. Definitely could use your help here, so this fucking guy. I just need to stay out of this guy's sight. I think that's the key to getting around him. Just when he goes. That, oh no, he can still catch you. Either way. If his back's turned to you or not. There's our checkpoint. Oh man, he always gets you. If you're there, he's gonna get you. Key with this stage is you just gotta keep moving. Like even with this guy, if you're close to him, it seems like you can get around him. Unless he's gonna get me there, because he comes at an angle. We're home free. Okay, so Crockhead Clamper. You're so cool. Oh, oh my God, I thought I saw him dropping down too.
Oh.
did I not see that? Sorry if I'm a little quiet here for a minute. I'm kind of just concentrating on this. This part always. I got the G there. I just wanted to land. I didn't even care at that point. I just didn't want to die on the B and do that again. Because those, when you land on those gator heads, they just feel so slippery that it's easy to be running and just lay off your jump button just enough where you're sliding to the swamp. So that stage always gives me a little anxiety. Like that Portrait of King K. Rool in the background. If anyone saw that? I wonder if this is like the abandoned ship from the first game, the one that you fight him on. Just in like a more detailed form, because that one's like seems like a little boat, but that'd be cool if this is the actual ship that you fought him on, and he just, you know, gave up on it. Like when he aborted his mission after Donkey Kong kicked his ass. Get that one. See him come down. Just snuck by him. There you go. Okay, slime climb. I'm not gonna like this stage. This is, you gotta move here pretty fast because of the piranha. Don't know why I thought I could get around that. Can you guys move any slower? Jesus. I hate that, because they're just like hanging out on the ropes and you're trying to go. So I really needed Diddy. Because I knew I was gonna take a hit with those guys. Really starts picking up now. Especially with these guys. It's pretty terrifying when. Woo! Oh my god, I don't know how I made it around that. I'm just gonna take it. Woo! Thank you. Not wanna do that again. Are you serious? Get out, Diddy. Oh my gosh. I thought I could make that. That's such bullshit. Like, you don't even know where the ledge is. There we go. I feel like that's what I was trying to do the first time. Do I really need to go all the way up here with these guys? Thank you. Not like that stage. How do you get to that token right there? Because I'm not swimming in that water with him. What's going on, Tony? Thanks for checking me out. This game does bring back a lot of memories for me as well. More one than two, because I played a lot more one. But I was saying earlier that two really, really fleshes out the series very well, and I can see why it's most people's favorite in the franchise. And it's definitely got a little bit more of a learning curve than the first one. The first one's great, and there's many challenging spots, but this one, it's just it doesn't hold your hand at all. It just you definitely jump right into like the difficult platforming like this in the first game. You wouldn't see this kind of stuff until late in the game, especially like the snow levels, but this game doesn't hold your hand at all. See. Definitely gonna take my time here. Okay, so bonus always helps. The thing too is you still can die in the bonus stages, so. Oh, it was right there. I'm not gonna make it. Damn. I'll gladly take a checkpoint right now. Thank you. That's just ridiculous. That was like no need to have enemies when it was already this fucking hard. Like, why do we need those guys placed there? Straight trolling me. Okay, so we definitely gotta go back here. That bear was like, fuck you. No. Jesus, I made that mistake. I already went that way. Hello. There we go. I think I found my way. This is some bullshit right here, too. Boom, boom, boom. Whew. Okay. Got it. Whew. Whew. Hate that stage. I definitely do not like it at all. That's okay. Cudgels contest. I thought this guy was so cool. Definitely should have been more of like King K. Rool's gatekeeper to just like his final chamber. You know, I would have him be like the second to last boss for like placement purposes. He's definitely like K. Rool's main guy, I think. Just could have given him a couple more moves, I think. Wouldn't hurt. Because he doesn't do much for a big dude. That worked out. Boom. I think he's got one more hit in him. There we go. Send him back to the bio. Okay, so we've gone through Creme Quay, Crocodile Cauldron, and Gangplank Galeon. So where are we now? We are at Crazy Kremlin. Looks like K. Rool's casino, like personal casino maybe. going on in here. It's like the honeycomb hideout. Hornet hole. Tony, if you're still watching, we need to play some N64 wrestling games like Revenge and No Mercy sometime. Oof, just made it through that. Oh, I don't know why I was thinking I was supposed to go down there when the bananas were clearly to the left side. Hello. Nice bonus. Okay, not sure, too sure if I need to hit a certain one or if there's another chest. I don't know what's going on there. I don't know how I missed that one, but I just didn't see it. Sometimes I almost forget that she has her, like, tailspin. Her hair spin. And, it definitely saves you in some, like, tight situations like that. I can just kind of glide over. I forget about it all the time. Shit. Okay. That was huge right now. Oh my gosh, this is very stress-inducing right here. Because I don't know what the fuck's going on. Where are they headed? Okay. Thank you. Now I'm getting the hang of it a little bit. Little trial and error with the stage because I'm not used to being stuck in sticky honey as I'm platforming through a beehive. There we go. Tony, if I had to take a guess, I would say this is your favorite DK country game in the series. It's really good. I was This one has like so many clenching moments when I'm playing. I was saying earlier it's a lot of people's, I feel like, for a good reason. And I have played some of the newer ones, like Donkey Kong Country Returns, and those games are very good. They're very challenging and they're beautiful games, but I feel like the way that the graphical style of these, of the original trilogy, like you can't replicate it. Like the environments, like the carnival, like this Target Terror, and just like the way it looks, like the overall appeal of it's like fantastic. And like I like the serious tone that they make Donkey Kong and Diddy have. Like I feel like the newer games, they're more like goofy kind of goofballs, but I feel like with these, like in this game, it's like this is like Diddy and DK are like badasses in this. I don't know, I've always felt like the tone in these games are a little more serious than the newer ones, but I don't know, maybe it's just how they look and design. But the stages are just amazing. Like this stage is so cool. Your finger's so geared towards just hitting barrels at this point that you just, regardless if there's a red X on, I still hit it sometimes. I was definitely supposed to get the token there, so let's see if I can still reach it. Nope, I didn't see it. Boom, boom. Okay, checkpoint. Definitely need that barrel big time. Such a little asshole. Okay. Oh my god, I just missed that. Okay, I definitely need to concentrate here, so. that's where I needed. I think that's where I... Oh, no. Shit. Even when you see the red X's on the barrels, you're still... You're just so used to jumping for a barrel when you see it, that it just naturally, it's instinct. And then you realize, nope, that's not what I'm supposed to do. But it's literally just like programmed in my head. I see a barrel, I jump. There we go. Nope, see, I did it again. I think I needed Diddy there to throw me up into that barrel. Either way, I made it, so. Bramble scramble. I'm just happy this entire... this entire subworld isn't just like honeycombs. So I'm happy it switches it up, but that would have drove me crazy if I had to just keep going, jumping over bumblebees. Oh. Definitely getting harder. Oh, I need that barrel so bad. Thank you so much. You gotta have to like drop them down on him. I don't need that O that bad. I'm not going after it. Thank you. They should just make a shooter, a Donkey Kong shooter, like this, the whole game. You just go through with this guy. This would be like a DK shmup. That'd be great. Just without the death spikes everywhere. Really? Oh my god. I don't know how I got around that. Dude, DK Cross Greatest would be great. I think we're onto something here. Whew. That was stressful. It's like stages like that, I feel like the game gets you like set up for the, like later on, like if you can get through this, you got it. Like you can take on King K. Rool at this point. Like, third place now? I'm like scared to blank. I'm very scared to blank right now. He keeps looking back like, gonna get you, boy. Yes, is this first place? That was close. That was like at the finish line I got him, so. So I'm wondering if I, is there a barrel up here? Yeah. Nope. Diddy, where'd you go? Okay, so we're moving on to did Rickety Race. Oh. Am I doing this right? There we go. Okay. Mudhole Marsh. Cat or something. I don't know what that guy is. Anyone remember Eek the Cat? Thank you. Jeez. I thought you would bounce on him. Hello. She wasn't that bad. It's nice getting some of those cannons every so often. Destroy them all. Okay. Boom. There we go. Oh, I was definitely supposed to use that
to get a item. His cannonball.
Clubus kiosk. Okay, Rambi Rumble.
Really know if I'm supposed to be going down here or not. I think so though.
Bumblebees are terrifying. That's what I needed. It's always nice to see those. Oh, that's why. That's why I need checkpoints. That's why we have them. Is this Rambi? Okay, now we got him. Awesome. An exterminator. Thanks, Rambi. Rambi's just a fucking boss, man. Look at him. He's plowing through shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess you just need to. Ooh. Okay. You just need to keep like, moving quick then. Holy shit, he moves fast. Jesus. That's a. Okay. So I just need to move quick, like really fast. Oh, wait, you know what? Oh, there's. I didn't even see that token up there. Okay, now he's here, so we gotta move quick. Fuck, I walked right into him. Jesus Christ. Move, Rampy, move. Okay. That wasn't bad. Okay, we did Rambi Rumble, so Zing Zing Sting, oh, King Zing Sting, so we're at the boss then, aren't we? Where is he? Okay. Whoop. Oh, there we go. We gotta get a stinger. Fight is really intense, or I'm just doing it wrong. Oof. Cause you had to hit him in the stinger. If I get really close to him, I can nail him. Got him. Just got him. I get him? Oh, not yet. So it gets really hard, I think, right? Hey, have a good night, Tony. What are you training tonight, by the way? Ghostly Grove. Nice. I did I did some chest and bicep at the gym, and they're requiring you to have masks on now. It's crazy the amount of people that just aren't doing it in general, like aren't following procedures and aren't wearing their masks. But if you're going somewhere, most places are requiring you to have a mask at the gym. I'm not sure where you're training at, but I went today, and it just, people just did not have masks on, so it's kind of crazy. But I mean, I had mine, I didn't have an issue with it. So but yeah, wherever you're going, have a good workout, dude. No, you gotta just keep throwing it. I'm assuming it's what's gonna happen, so. I'm gonna wait for that guy. Okay. Time to move, Diddy. Ghost ropes are awesome. Get one more shot. Got it. Whew. That one wasn't bad. That was like a leap of faith you kind of have to take, hoping these things will reappear. Oh my, oh. I did not just do that. Oh man. Please tell me I got a checkpoint. Yep, okay. Thank you. I was like, any second, those ghost ropes will reappear, right? I was getting really nervous on those jumps. Okay. Haunted Hall. Is it anything like the Haunted Mansion? Oh, this one. This is like getting the fuel from the first game. If you run out of fuel, you either die or you take a hit. Oh, did I find a bonus? Very cool. I like that. That's kind of like a throwback to the bonuses in the first game, where you're just collecting like little golden character coins. You need every last one of these green barrels. Thank you, checkpoint. Oh, whew, I really thought I was gonna hit that one. No! That was aggressive. Oh my gosh, that was awesome. I just made that. Okay, Gusty Glade. Those levels in the lost levels in Mario. It was like wind stages. This reminds me of. I don't know if they move randomly or if this wind moves at certain times of the stage, but I'm guessing. Oh shit. That was my own fault. I'm guessing it's where you're. Wherever you're at on the stage, it's gonna move certain directions, so. Thank you. Ooh. Took that right to the face. Oh, damn. Dude's like laid me out. Son of a bitch. There we go. Her hair spin's gonna definitely come in handy here, because. I didn't want to overshoot it there, so. Okay, parrot to panic. Whoops, did not mean to do that. Who needs a parachute when you got, Dixie, right? Just kind of like the same thing. Just when I thought I was done with these honeycomb stages, there's more of them. Okay, that works. Are you serious? Okay, that worked. I was like, I'm gonna be so mad if I lost Dixie. Slow here. Oh, that checkpoint was huge. Okay, let's go. Biggest thing is just trying to figure out your hitbox. Like, if the parrot getting hit, or is Diddy and Dixie getting hit when these bumblebees touch them? So I'm trying to figure out. I don't need those gold coins that bad. You can keep them. They'll forever be with you. Buddy, let's get through this. All right, that was tough. I'm telling you, man, those honeycomb ones are intense. Okay, Webwoods. Assuming we're gonna get the little spider guy back again, so. This has got to be the coolest character you play as in the game. As like the little sidekicks. Stage. Edwin, like, fighting all of these Nekis, Jesus. So many. Like, how many of these do we need to fight? Although there's gonna be one like every couple of feet. See, even the fucking game's telling you to go back. This is bullshit with the fucking arrows. Ooh. Why was the cannon going so slow? I hate this stage. Ooh. Stage is the worst stage, I swear. Through Nekiville. Just keep fighting these dudes. Fucking ass, man. Ugh. There we go. Where are these bees at? God, thank God. That stage is so hard. Ugh. Okay, Creepy Crow. I think anything's better than that last stage. So if this is a boss, I'm okay with it. So is it Ghost Necky? Okay. There's a real Necky. Oh, so if you hit the real one, I think you get a barrel, right? Yep.
dude. Oh, no.
Okay. Round two. He's quick.
I need a Diddy there so I could just kind of walk right into him with the barrel. Oh my gosh, I killed him too. Damn it. That was tough. Just in time. Come on. Jeez. Those fucking eggs. It's not even him. Let's do this. Hope I can survive. Oh my god, that's hard. Okay. I really gotta concentrate here. Okay, I'm starting to figure out that the barrels are gonna come whatever direction you are, so. Kidding me, like I keep killing him. I really needed her too. I don't have an issue getting this part now. It's mainly just not fucking up. There we go. Okay. If I'm gonna beat him, it's gonna be here. On this guy. Oh, I didn't know I could kill them. That makes it a lot easier. Got him. That was really hard. I beat him though. Took like a ton of tries. Okay, so we are at K Rool's Keep. Still. Okay, I needed that. There we go.
was huge and definitely needed a checkpoint. Dude. I saw those guys, I was like, I'm done for. That's close. Definitely a very challenging water level. I knew I was gonna take a hit there.
Oh, I know I was gonna hit that guy. Where was the parrot the whole time? I didn't know there's you could play through with him. Alright, Collin College. I definitely need to save. Castle Crush. Okay, I definitely need to rack up some one-ups now, so. I had no clue you could kill him like that. Definitely needed that checkpoint big time. And that barrel. Thank you. This is like the gauntlet right here. I think I was supposed to have him in there with me. Oh, that's such bullshit. I don't know how he snuck in there, but he did. Yeah, it was gonna be impossible with that Crusher. That dude coming out. Ooh! I can't believe I got that. I got super lucky. Probably tell with these later stages I get very, very into it. So if I'm quiet, sorry guys, I'm just kind of concentrating right now trying to get through this. He's doing over here. I don't know what he's doing. This guy dies. Not want to get stuck with him. This is it right here. I probably needed that barrel, but I don't care. I just needed to get through that stage. Clapper's Cavern. They don't really give you much time at all to get through this, do they? Oh, that was so good. Got it. All right. Chain link chamber. I think I'm gonna save real fast. Okay. college. Okay, chain link chamber. Probably like another. Oh my gosh, this one. Okay. Let's try that again. I feel like by the end of Donkey Kong Country, you've mastered like every type of mechanic this game has to offer, because it definitely incorporates everything you've learned throughout the game, and it progresses as it gets harder. So oh my gosh, that's ridiculous. Where's the checkpoint? Okay, where are these guys going?
These are terrifying. I was wondering, like, there's no checkpoint. There we go. This is such a cool stage. You really gotta keep moving. Such a like piratey theme, this stage. Like the soundtrack here. All my coins. I guess when you turn the game off, you lose all your coins, but I had like a ton of coins. I don't know what's going on with that. Thank you.
Oh, this is awesome. The flying croc. Okay, Screech's sprint. All right, guys, let's go save DK. Oh no. Oh! Yeah. Oh, I was right there too. These jumps are really intense. There we go. I gotta really take my time there. Supposed to beat this asshole. He moves really fast. Chance now if I just keep with him. There we go. Ooh, that was really intense. Oh my gosh. You really can't stop moving for a split second. Like, I couldn't even think of what I was doing. Oh, that's what I needed really bad. I needed to save. Saved, so. Just to make sure. I'm saving that twice. Because I think I'm right there. Let's see what he does. Come on, K-Rool. Thank you. One more shot. Oh my god, no. Crap. That came at me just so fast. I keep forgetting that he's gonna shoot that cannon afterwards. It's a really badass, like, final boss song. Alright guys, let's do this. I think Dixie will help a lot here. Really? Oh my god. Same spot. Thank you. was so close. Job. Okay, come on, I got this. I'm really messing up. There we go. Oh, thank God. I thought I was getting up. I knew you'd do it, Diddy, my boy, but how could you fail, having learned all you know from old Cranky here? Yeah, he's much harder. K-Roll is much harder in part 2. That gas on the last round is really tough to get around. I reckon I had found all the Krem coins and completed the so-called Lost World. Oh well, can't expect everything from you first gamers, can we? One more thing, how many of my special video game hero coins did you find? So I gotta come back and at least attempt the Lost World. Guys, so that's my playthrough of Donkey Kong Country 2. Those last few stages are very difficult, and that last battle with K. Rool is really challenging. Especially that last race with the bird that you go up against. I got really lucky with that. But yeah, overall, I really love this game. It's a It's a big improvement over the first one as far as platforming. It looks gorgeous. The first one looked great too, don't get me wrong. Soundtrack, definitely improved. I love the original, but this one's just so good as well. And it just, everything feels like a continuation of the first game. It just feels more fleshed out. There's more lore. There's, you know, the all the hidden secrets in this game. Just the fact that you are going through kind of like the Krem world, K. Rool's home turf, as I guess you could say. But and it just really fleshes out those characters, who the Kremlings are. You know, you kind of knew in the first game they came to Kong Island and you know, took his banana hoard. But what was their, you know, where are they from? You know, what is their attachment with DK? And you kind of learn a little more about that, and you just learn about who they are more, and that they really flesh out their whole pirate theme, because I mean that's what they were in the first one. But I mean, if you play through the first game, you couldn't really tell the Kremlings so much were a band of pirates. But I mean, in this game they really, really flesh those, you know, characters out. So I love that. And yeah, just a very challenging game overall. So you can probably tell by my playthrough, I had a lot more challenge with this one than I did DK Country 1. DK Country 1, I can easily sit down and play through the whole game on one run. But this one's just got, you know, a lot more gimmicks, a lot more just variation, I guess, in it altogether. So, yeah. I've never gone back and beaten all the lost levels in this game, or the lost world. So, that's something I want to do here soon. But I'm not done streaming for now. I'm gonna do some Mario World next. So when this ends, we're gonna jump into that for a little bit. But I will be taking a look at Donkey Kong Country 3 here soon, and that is the only game in the trilogy I have not beaten. I've gotten very far in it. I played through most of it, so it's just those later stages. I didn't give up on it, but I think I just stepped back from it. Like, I played majority of it, and I just something came up where I put it down. So that's something that's been calling me now. Now I have no excuses. I just played through 1 and 2, so you know, the game's fresh in my head. I need to go in and play 3. So we are going to be looking at Donkey Kong Country 3 this week at some point. So we are going to beat it. I'm going to sit there, make sure I finally finish that game. Is that Glimmer? The Kong Clan. Swanky. Funky Kong. Wrinkly. Good old Cranky. Donkey Kong. But where's Donkey Kong Jr., huh? Dixie. Diddy Kong. Diddy Kong's Quest. I'd like to know if anybody knows the Kong lineages or the Kong family tree. Like I know it's out there, but I don't really know it fresh. I'd like to know how they're all related or how they all kind of came about. I think there's a ROM hack out there, or there's a hack where you can, of Donkey Kong Country 1, where they actually have Donkey Kong Jr. in the game, like the original DK Jr. sprite, and that's really cool. But yeah, you would think, with Cranky getting old, you would think this Donkey Kong is DK Jr., but apparently it's not, so they really need to bring him back as a character. Such a good ending theme song. This song's awesome. So, Super Mario World next, guys. Here in just a second, I wanna see if there's anything comes at the end of these ending credits. We're gonna jump into that next. Rare Systems and Silicon Graphics for the hardware. Very cool. Alright guys, so that's it. Donkey Kong Country 2.